Airports. For some people, they're just a place you go to catch a plane to fly somewhere different than where you are already. Airports are more than just a place where planes take flight and land again once the experience of flight comes to an end. Airports are gateways to the world. With a mile of road, you can travel a mile. But with a mile of runway, you can fly anywhere in the world. In the year of 2020, people have been flying heavier-than-air aircraft for over 100 years. And few airports and artifacts from earlier beginnings of aviation remain in the world today. However, one airport that has seen it all still exists today, and is located just east of Cincinnati, Ohio. Aviation activity in the Little Miami River Valley had been going on since the year of 1920. Then, in 1925, what was once just a landing strip for Barnstormer pilots became the Cincinnati Lunken Airport. Cincinnati's gateway to the world. Lunken Airport is still open today, and while the golden days of aviation have unfortunately passed, Lunken remains to be a hidden diamond in the dirt that not many people realize the historic value of the airport. But with this documentary, hopefully more people will learn about and enjoy the story of Lunken Airport, Cincinnati's hidden aviation gem. Aviation activity in the area that is now known as Lunken Airport began in the early 1920s, not too long after the First World War. The war produced a lot of planes and even more pilots. A good portion of the pilots got out of the military after the war and wanted to keep flying, so most of them became what are known as Barnstormer pilots, a sort of daredevil stunt pilot, you could say. Barnstormers in the Cincinnati area began to use flat land in the Little Miami River Valley as a common landing strip. This area was known by locals as Turkey Bottoms, and no, it wasn't named after a turkey's rear end. The area was known as Turkey Bottoms because of a massive wild turkey population in the valley. In 1921, probably the most famous local barnstorming pilot, John Dixon Davis, commonly known as just Dixie Davis, started giving flight lessons at Turkey Bottoms. Dixie Davis also offered flights to people, charging 2 cents per pound, which translates to roughly around 26 cents in today's currency. Before Turkey Bottoms really took off, there is another airfield in the Cincinnati area. Officially opened in 1921, Grizzard Field nearby Blue Ash, Ohio, opened with one dirt runway and multiple hangars. Grizzard was also the home of the newly established 359th U.S. Army Reserve Squadron. Before Turkey Bottoms began, Grizzard is where all the local pilots flew, including former U.S. Army pilot John Paul Riddle. Sometime in 1923, local industrialist Shelby F. Lunken, a partner of the Grizzard Company, aka the company who owned Grizzard Field, met with the wealthy investor Tilton Higby Embry in Blue Ash, where they discussed aviation and its potential to drive the century. Eventually, the two met up with local pilot John Paul Riddle, who also agreed with Lunken and Embry in their ideas. Riddle ended up becoming very close to Embry and taught him how to fly. Lunken and Embry had the money, and Riddle had the aviation knowledge. They all then decided to leave Grizzard and head south to Turkey Bottoms in search of land for expansion and better access to Cincinnati's city transportation system. In 1924, Turkey Bottoms officially became known as Lunken Airport. Seeing the opportunity south at Turkey Bottoms, Army Major E.L. Hoffman moved the 359th Reserve Squadron from Grizzard to Lunken. The Reserve Squadron also moved 2 hangars from Grizzard down to Lunken with them, which can still be found at the east end of Airport Road today. In 1925, Riddle and Embry came together to form the Embry-Riddle Flying School at Lunken, which is now ERAU, or the Embry-Riddle Aeronautical University. Embry-Riddle actually wasn't just a flight school when they started out, they also offered different transportation services and aerial photography. In 1927, famous aviator Charles Lindbergh visited Cincinnati on his cross-country tour shortly after his historic solo Atlantic crossing. His celebrity status drew thousands of onlookers in the Cincinnati and northern Kentucky areas to Lunken to attempt to catch a glimpse of Lindbergh and his aircraft, the Spirit of St. Louis. During his visit to Cincinnati, he gave a speech about commercial aviation at Redland Field, the then home of the Cincinnati Reds. His speech sparked interest in aviation in the thousands of Cincinnatians who had seen him. Coincidentally, at the time, the Lunken Airport Company, or the LAC, had been discussing developing Lunken into a municipal airport. Lindbergh's visit provided the boost in public momentum needed, and in the fall of 1927, Cincinnati voters approved of an $800,000 bond issue to expand and upgrade Lunken to become a municipal airport. With those upgrades would come the construction of hangars 1, 2, and 3, all of which still remain at the airport today, and updated lighting to help with night landings. In the years following Lindbergh's historic visit, both airline and airmail traffic continued to grow out of Lunken, and with the recently approved bond issue, the construction of Lunken's first terminal and three additional hangars had begun. However, in 1929, the Little Miami and Ohio Rivers both overflowed their banks and flooded the airfield. This flood was nothing too major, but was enough to close down the field for multiple days. After this flood, the city of Cincinnati planned to spend $145,000 to build a levee around the airport ranging from around 18 to 25 feet tall, along with a water pumping station. Later in 1929, five businessmen incorporated the Aeronautical Corporation of America, later to become Aeronca, to build the first light aircraft for recreational use. Aeronca is recognized today as the first manufacturer of a commercially successful light aircraft. Aeronca had a factory at Lunken where they built several different airframes up until the 1937 flood, and they then decided to move to Middletown, Ohio to continue production. The Aeronca factory still stands today at 645 Wilmer Avenue, and today is used by an aircraft rental service known as Reynolds Jet. Also at Lunken with Aeronca was the Metal Aircraft Company. The Metal Aircraft Company is most famously known for producing the Flamingo C-2, one of the first all-metal aircraft, which at the time was still very uncommon. At the time, most aircraft were still built using mostly wood and fabrics. In September of 1930, more than 25,000 people attended a three-day dedication of Lunken at Cincinnati's Municipal Airport. During the dedication, the one and only Howard Hughes had actually sponsored an aerobatic competition at the airport that spanned from September 27th through the 28th. Up until the dedication, the airport had been known as Lunken Airport, or Lunken Field, but at the ceremony, they had just made the name official. In 1932, after a merger with Avco, Embry-Riddle decided to move its headquarters and most of its employees out west to St. Louis, Missouri, to merge with Avco's new subsidiary, American Airways. In 1934, American Airways became American Airlines and would become a major carrier out of Lunken for many years to come. American Airways would also eventually take over Embry-Riddle's old hangar at Lunken. By 1936, Lunken had become the largest commercial airport in the United States. Lunken had two concrete runways measuring 4,028 feet. Only three other airports in the world enjoyed this luxury and were larger than Lunken: London, England, Paris, France, and Berlin, Germany. Lunken's traffic numbers continued to grow larger and larger as time went on, and it became apparent that Lunken would need a new modern terminal building to accommodate the growing passenger numbers. In 1936, work began on Lunken's brand new terminal. The new terminal would have features such as 9 ticket counters, office space, and even a new restaurant called the Sky Chef. You can actually still stop by and grab a bite to eat at the Sky Chef today, although now you may know it by its new name, the Sky Galley. Fun fact, it is actually called the Sky Galley today because back then, the in-flight meals on American Airlines flights used to be prepared in the restaurant's kitchen. Blessed day, the dark sacred night. Construction on Lunken's brand new terminal was nearing completion in January of 1937 when disaster struck. The combination of Lunken being built on a floodplain and being situated right next to both the Ohio and Little Miami rivers set the pieces in place for a devastating flood if one worse enough were to ever happen. After smaller floods in the past, the city of Cincinnati had built a levee completely surrounding the airport and a water pumping station, but none of those precautions would be able to save Lunken from what was to come. From January 13th through the 24th, record-setting rainfall was recorded in the Midwest of the United States, and by the time the rains had slowed, the floodwaters in the Cincinnati area had reached 80 feet above the normal river level, and Lunken Airport had been entirely submerged underwater, with only the rooftops of hangars and the newly constructed terminal being visible. flights were canceled for a total of 17 days, the longest shutdown Lunken had ever experienced up until the point. This flood would ultimately change Lunken's future as Cincinnati's commercial airport. In the year of 1938, the new airport terminal building was officially opened and dedicated with the Lunken name, and more than 75,000 people attended the opening ceremony. The terminal was initially scheduled to be finished and opened in 1937, however, due to the disastrous 1937 flood, in which Lunken's nickname Sunken Lunken comes from, the opening was pushed back a whole year. The terminal still stands today, and its Art Deco styling and its history make it one of Cincinnati's most iconic landmarks. In 1938, an American Airlines Douglas DC-3 inbound from New York City skidded off a runway and hit a levee just off the end of the runway. The aircraft was about to touch down when a strong gust of wind blew the aircraft to the left of the runway. 3 out of the 11 people on board were hospitalized, and American Airlines estimated the damage to cost around $60,000, or just over $1 million in today's currency. For the longest time, American Airlines completely dominated out of Lunken Airport, only being rivaled by smaller airmail airlines, which didn't really carry passengers. However, this would change in 1941. Lunken's new control tower was a feature not too many airports had at the time, and airlines took notice of this. In early 1941, Transcontinental and Western Airlines, or TNWA, and Delta Airlines decided to take a jump into the Cincinnati market. TNWA decided to take on American Airlines directly, mostly copying American's route network out of Lunken with a few additional routes of their own, while Delta Airlines focused on providing a needed commercial link to the southern United States that was missing from Cincinnati. Delta flew routes to and from Atlanta, Georgia, out of Lunken.
Yesterday, December 7th, 1941, a date which will live in infamy, the United States of America was suddenly and deliberately attacked by naval and air forces of the Empire of Japan. The United States was at peace with that nation, and at the solicitation of Japan, was still in conversation with its government and its emperor, looking toward the maintenance of peace in the Pacific.
By December of 1941, when the Japanese attacked American forces in Hawaii, the war in Europe had been going on for 2 years, and while the United States had chosen to remain neutral, the attacks on Pearl Harbor officially launched the United States into the Second World War. Lunken Airport had been very successful as a civilian airport up until 1941 and was the largest civilian airport in the United States. Almost all civilian air travel was put on hold to put all possible resources towards the war effort, and civilian airports were assigned a new duty, and Lunken was about to see a major increase in air traffic. At the start of the United States' involvement in the war, Lunken became part of the transportation system that provided worldwide strategic airlift. The United States' Army Air Force's Air Transport Command Ferrying Division's mission was to provide aircraft for combat, training, air evacuation of war casualties, and the transportation of troops and cargo. Just to sum all that up, basically Lunken was a hub for all things military during the war. Lunken was mainly used as a cargo hub for freight movement and a training field for U.S. military pilots. At its peak, Lunken Airport was handling an average of 11,000 aircraft operations per month. While the World War II period was the busiest period in Lunken Airport's history, it had also been the period with the highest number of aircraft crashes in its history. From August 9, 1941 to August 12, 1945, there were a total of 13 aircraft incidents. All aircraft were either on their way to the airport or had just taken off from Lunken. Of the 13 crashes, 2 were civilian aircraft, while the others were various types of U.S. military aircraft. During the war, aircraft operations had also been taking place in nearby Boone County, Kentucky. In 1944, the United States Congress had approved of a plan to buy farm fields and turn into an airfield with two runways that could be used by B-17 bombers to perform practice missions. The Army would declare the airfield in Boone County to be surplus after the war, but the airfield would begin to receive airmail routes later in the year. After the war, Lunken Airport would return to its previous operations and would serve as Cincinnati's hub for all things aviation for two more years until 1947. Lunken Airport, throughout its days up until 1947, had proven it can be a very successful airport and made the city of Cincinnati lots of money. It had even proven that it can still remain an economic booster even during a wartime period. However, even with everything that was great about Lunken, its flaws overshadowed its true potential. Lunken's constant flooding and the introduction of larger airliners meant Lunken, in its current state at the time, was unfit to continue as Cincinnati's commercial airport in the eyes of the airlines. On October 26, 1946, the former Army airfield in Boone County, Kentucky, finished construction of a wooden terminal building and the airfield prepared for commercial service. The airfield, while being located even farther away from downtown Cincinnati than Lunken Airport, decided to open under the name of the Greater Cincinnati Airport in an attempt to attract commercial airline service. On January 10, 1947, the very last commercial flights from American Airlines, TNWA, and Delta Airlines would take place at Lunken Airport, and later that day, the three airlines would begin service to the Greater Cincinnati Airport. This move left Lunken with no scheduled commercial airlines. However, this would only be a small bump in Lunken's runway to success. Lunken had always been a very general aviation-focused airport, and still is today. However, from 1947 up until the late 1950s, Lunken actually held the title of the busiest general aviation airport in the world. There is no doubt the 1960s were a very interesting decade in the United States' history, and there were some very interesting visitors and airline activity at Lunken in this decade. In the year of 1963, after nearly 16 years of commercial airline absence at Lunken Airport, Edmund P. Lunken started an airline known as Midwest Airways that would be based out of Lunken Airport. Midwest Airways would operate exclusively in the Midwest of the United States, flying to Columbus, Cleveland, Detroit, and Chicago, all out of Lunken Airport. Midwest Airways operated a small fleet of one aircraft type, which is the Lockheed 10A Electra, which wasn't necessarily the most advanced aircraft at the time, but they were perfect for the short business travel focused routes that Midwest Airways flew. This airline unfortunately would not last very long, and this wasn't because they had trouble filling their seats on the flights, rather they couldn't keep the seats filled. This airline, while short-lived, did bring attention back to Lunken, and other airlines would take note of their strategy. One of the airlines was actually headquartered at Lunken today. In 1964, the FAA would officially designate the Cincinnati Lunken Airport as a general aviation reliever airport for the Greater Cincinnati Northern Kentucky Airport. In 1965, with business jet travel expanding, it was decided that Lunken needed a new runway to accommodate this traffic. Later in the year, runway 21 left, 3 right, a 6,100-foot long runway was built. However, to build this runway, the city of Cincinnati redirected the path of the Little Miami River to gain the land needed to build the new runway. Even with the redirection of the Little Miami River, the infield of the airport still floods today. And no, this wasn't a mistake, rather this is supposed to happen. This is a unique flood managing tactic, which I don't know personally too much about, I'm more into the airplanes. But apparently it works. The airfield runways themselves don't flood, it's mainly the surrounding areas in the infield that take on most of the water. In the 1960s, the Beatles would visit Cincinnati twice, once in August of 1964 and once again in August of 1966. While the Beatles played at two different venues in Cincinnati, their landing spot both times was the same. Yep, that's right. Both times the Fab Four came to the Queen City, they chartered a plane into Lunken Airport. Now I bet you're wondering, why Lunken and not the Greater Cincinnati Airport? Well, with the Beatles being the superstars they were, they would need a strong security presence to ensure they were safe. And well, there wasn't any one strong, unified law enforcement agency in northern Kentucky. So, the Beatles decided to fly into Lunken Airport, which is in the city of Cincinnati, city limits, so they could gain the protection and resources of the Cincinnati Police Department. Many high-profile guests, including presidents and other politicians flying into the city of Cincinnati, have also chosen to fly into Lunken rather than CBG for this exact reason. To end off the 1960s, the Blue Horizons Travel Club actually operated Douglas DC-7s to exotic destinations out of Lunken Airport. They did this through the early 1970s as well. However, this didn't continue much long after. Well, after the 1960s, there are a few decades that go by where, in terms of historic importance, nothing really happened at Lunken. The airport would continue to be Cincinnati's primary general aviation airport at the time, and Lunken's main thriving business was actually flight schools. The world-famous Sporty's Pilot Shop and Flight School is actually based at Lunken from 1961 up until the early 1990s when they made the move to the nearby Claremont County Airport. In the background for this chapter, I've chosen to include a home video made by Falcon Great Lakes 2 on YouTube showing what Lunken Airport was like in January of 1990. While there's a pause in the video here, I'm just going to take a second to thank everybody for watching. I hope you really enjoyed the documentary, and if you have, please go leave a like, maybe even a kind comment. And if you aren't already, go ahead and hit the subscribe button, hit the notification button, and make sure you get alerted anytime I post a video. If you really enjoyed this documentary, I do want to do more documentaries on other airports in the future. So yeah, just go ahead and let me know. But for now, let's get right back into the video. It's getting late, my friend, my love, I miss you so. Take good care of you, I've gotta go. For a long time now, Lunken Airport has hosted all sorts of air shows and other aviation-related events, but none of these would be as big as the Lunken Airport Air Show in 2003. This air show was massive. You might even compare it to the show hosted in Oshkosh, Wisconsin every year. There's everything from historic warbirds, aerobatic competitions, and even several vintage airliners. My grandfather actually attended this air show in 2003, and he, being a huge military aviation fan, said he had a blast watching all the warbirds at the show. Lunken still hosts multiple air shows a year, with the most common aircraft to be featured being the B-17 Flying Fortress by the name of Aluminum Overcast, and the Boeing B-29 Super Fortress by the name of Fifi. Now that I've discussed Lunken's air shows, let's talk a little bit more about the two other things that most Cincinnatians know Lunken for. I talked about it a little bit back in Chapter 8, but probably one thing that Lunken Airport's most known for is its restaurant, the Sky Galley. The Sky Galley originally opened back in 1938 as the Sky Chef, and over the years it has gone through a few different name changes. The restaurant is known for its amazing view of the airfield and its really good diner-style food. The Sky Galley also has a bar, and throughout the restaurant you can find all sorts of cool model airplanes and historic aviation photographs. In 2019, the lease agreement for the restaurant was nearly canceled by the city of Cincinnati due to potential food safety risk reported by the health department. After an online petition on change.org gained over 17,000 signatures, an agreement was reached in which the city would provide up to $100,000 to help renovate the restaurant and grant it another 5-year lease if the owner committed to correcting the violations. The owner of the Sky Galley unfortunately did not accept the city's deal, and on September 20th of 2020, the Sky Galley was shut down for good. The other thing most Cincinnatians know Lunken for is its 5-mile bike trail that surrounds the entire airport. I've walked this trail many times over the years, and I do enjoy walking the trail as you get to see all sorts of cool different views at the airport while still getting some exercise. I personally like to just walk the trail, but many people also take their bikes out and ride the trail. Fun fact, most people don't actually realize this, but most of the trail is actually on top of a levee that was supposed to keep floodwaters from the Ohio and Little Miami rivers from flooding the airport. The city of Cincinnati, in an effort to continue making money even if the airport itself isn't performing well, had chosen to build a park and golf course north to the airport for public use. Got it all, and ooh, that kiss of fire, it makes you wanna climb the wall. Well, I'm a fool. Yep. Ultimate Air Shuttle started operations in the year of 2009, shortly after the merger of Delta Airlines and Northwest Airlines in an attempt to serve destinations on a time-driven basis. Ultimate would become a very heavily business travel-oriented airline serving airports closest to the actual cities they flew to. Ultimate launched service out of CVG and Lunken with flights to New York and soon to expand to Chicago in 2010. In 2012, Detroit and Washington, D.C. were added as destinations, but the Detroit route was discontinued later that year, and the Washington, D.C. route was switched to Charlotte, North Carolina in 2013. In October of 2015, Ultimate began service to Cleveland, and flights to Delta Peachtree Airport in Atlanta and Nashville International Airport were indicated as the next cities with service to be added in the coming year. In May of 2016, Ultimate Air Shuttle announced it would move its CVG flights to Lunken in order to add an extra daily flight to Chicago Midway and New York City. During the COVID-19 pandemic, Ultimate Air Shuttle temporarily cut its scheduled charter routes to all of its destinations in an attempt to just ride out the pandemic. In the summer of 2020, Ultimate restarted service to Atlanta and Cleveland from Lunken. However, business travel demand was not in the right spot, so Ultimate made the decision to once again suspend services. This time, service would be suspended until spring of 2021. Ultimate Air Shuttle operates a fleet of 11 aircraft, 2 Embraer E-135s, and 9 of the jet variant of the Dornier 328. Ultimate Air Shuttle operates out of the smaller private terminals out of the airports they fly to, and with this, passengers who fly on Ultimate can get the advantage of not having to go through long security lines, and instead can use that time to relax in very nice airport lounges before and after the flights. In the year of 2013, a very special aircraft visited Lunken Airport. This aircraft was a single-seat monoplane that flew on only solar power. This aircraft was one of the first of its kind. This aircraft was known as the Solar Impulse, and in 2013 it conducted a multi-stage flight across the United States, stopping at multiple major cities, including Cincinnati, on its cross-country journey. This aircraft was originally supposed to fly directly from St. Louis to Washington, D.C., but made an extra stop in Cincinnati due to some bad storms in the aircraft's intended flight path. The aircraft landed at Lunken Airport in the evening and spent the night at Lunken to wait out the weather before taking off for Washington, D.C. in the following morning. Over the years, Lunken has had some pretty cool visitors fly through the airport, but some of the most interesting visitors have been U.S. presidents. President George W. Bush flew into Lunken Airport in October of 2007 when he came to Cincinnati to attend a fundraiser for Republican Congressman Steve Chabot. Even more recently, President Donald J. Trump has flown to Lunken Airport on multiple occasions for both campaign events and to speak to local business leaders. Besides presidents, many other politicians and political candidates have visited Lunken over the years. Most notably, Joe Biden, John McCain, Mitt Romney, Mike Pence, and even Ohio Governor Mike DeWine have flown into Lunken and had events at the airport. When most people think of Air Force One, they think of the iconic Boeing 747. However, every time a president or vice president has used Lunken, they have flown in on the C-32, which is a modified military version of the Boeing 757-200. This is because the 747 everyone knows and loves is just simply too big of a jet for Lunken to handle, so they normally bring the smaller but still medium-sized C-32 because of its ability to take off and land on shorter runways that other aircraft of its size otherwise couldn't land on. As you've all now learned, if you didn't know already, Lunken Airport has had a very long and interesting history and continues to live on even today as Cincinnati's primary general aviation and charter airport. However, there is one important question that, while might sound like a silly question, is very fair and interesting. That question is, can Lunken survive? In an always changing aviation business, where bigger jets that can fly longer distances tend to be a more trending topic, how can little old Lunken survive the changing times? In an interview with Lunken's airport manager, Fred Anderton, when asked about the future of Lunken's iconic Art Deco terminal and hangars, he said, "A lot of cities tear down without regard to what they're losing. I want to preserve these buildings, but to do so, I have to find a new revenue within the budget." He continued, "When there's a flood, you need to pump the water. You have to maintain the fields, the runways, the lighting. Those are our priorities. And when we talk about changing anything in the terminal, anything, you have to remember that many people walk in here and appreciate nothing so much that it feels exactly the way it did 60 years ago." The city of Cincinnati isn't known for being the best with money, and the airport being owned by the city falls under the city of Cincinnati's annual budget, and the airport's yearly budget, rather than going towards making improvements or growing the airport, goes towards basic airport maintenance, which is needed because that's all they have the money for. However, this isn't necessarily a negative thing. Despite a low budget to work with, the Cincinnati Lunken Airport brings in millions of dollars in landing fees, hangar rentals, and fuel sales annually, and the money earned only continues to grow with Lunken's traffic continuing to grow each year. This traffic is mostly built up of general aviation, military aviation, and scheduled air charter service from airlines like Ultimate Air Shuttle. Lunken is currently home to Ultimate Air Shuttle, the Lunken Flight Training Center, and multiple fixed base operators, along with the bases of multiple local businesses' corporate jet fleets, such as Kroger and Procter & Gamble. So back to the question, can Lunken survive? Well, the answer is very simple. Yes, Lunken Airport has been through many ups and downs in its history, and has always managed to pull through. There is no reason for the airport to close anytime in the near future, and as long as business travel and general aviation continues to grow and thrive, Lunken Airport is here to stay. Airports like Lunken aren't just important for the economy and travelers, but are also important for introducing some of the world's future contributors to the world of aviation, to the wonders of flight. The Wright brothers didn't just decide that they were going to pioneer the world's first airplane one day. Their father gave them a small rubber band helicopter toy when they were younger, and both the brothers later said that that little toy inspired them to be the first of mankind to ever fly a heavier-than-air aircraft. And that experience of flight for the Wright brothers led them to change the world forever. Airports like Lunken are that first experience of flight for some people. And hey, you may never know. The next Wright brothers could be just some kids watching planes at Lunken. Millions of people have had lunch at the Sky Galley, taken a flight, chased their dreams of flying by learning to fly at one of Lunken's flight schools, came to an air show, or just sat back and watched aircraft take to the skies. Lunken is not just an airport, it's a birthplace of dreams, and its history and the stories of those who have been there will live on for centuries. The Cincinnati Lunken Airport is Cincinnati's aviation gem.